Welcome to my channel. We're going to be bleaching the knots on this transparent lace closure, turning it into this. So stay tuned. To start off, you're going to need a sheet of aluminum foil, some bleaching powder and developer, a mixing bowl and brush, neutralizing shampoo, and popsicle sticks. I'm using a transparent lace closure from my brand, House of Vane. Here, I'm just combing the hair out of the way to make sure that I don't accidentally bleach any strands of hair. You really want to focus the bleach on the knots or else your hair is going to be blonde. My bleach and powder does come with this little scooper, so I used about 1.5 scoops, and I know I was out of the frame, I'm so sorry, but I used 1.5 scoops of powder, and in order to control the consistency of the mixture, I used the cap of my developer to add it in, and I used about 3 capfuls in the beginning. When I started mixing it, I noticed that it was not as creamy as I want it to be. Definitely don't want it watery, but it does need to be creamy is the best word that I could think of. So when I noticed that it was not how it needed to be, I did go ahead and add 2 more capfuls of developer to get the consistency that I needed. This is the consistency that you will be looking for before you bleach your lace. It's creamy, so I would say something like peanut butter. Is easy to spread, but it's not so watery that it'll seep through your lace and also bleach your hair, which is not what we're trying to do. When you're spreading this all over the back, you don't want to be like heavy-handed. You want to use a light hand. You don't want to scrape it because you don't want it to leak through to the hair, as I said before, but you just want to keep a light hand and place this all over the closure. Now that that's done, I'm flipping my closure around so that it can be face down on my aluminum foil, and I also wrap my aluminum foil, close it tight so that no air can get into it. And I placed 25 minutes on my timer. 10 minutes into the timer, I did come back to check on the closure just to make sure that everything was working how it was supposed to work and nothing was seeping through or anything. And it wasn't, but the knots did start to turn brown, but it still has some ways to go with that. I like to part through the hair as well to make sure that I'm looking at all the knots, not just the knots on the hairline, which sometimes can bleach faster. But then I closed it up again and I came back 20 minutes later to rinse it out. After I wash all the bleach out, I like to wash the closure in a neutralizing shampoo. I really massage that into the closure really well to make sure that there are no traces of bleach left in the hair at all. And then I rinse it off as usual. The last thing I like to do is add some conditioner to keep the hair soft, and that was it. It's very simple to bleach your knots. Imagine coming from a closure that looks like this, very unrealistic because we don't have black dots on our scalps, to a closure that now looks like this and will blend very nicely with your installs. I'm going to be making a wig out of this closure, but next I have to pluck my hairline. Now the closures and the frontals on my brand do come pre-plucked. As you can see in the front row, it's plucked, but the back is very obvious where they stopped plucking, so I would definitely recommend going in and doing some more plucking on your own, and I have a video on that coming up next, so just watch that. Like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and thank you so much for watching.